Hi guys, welcome back. I hope you all are doing great and I hope you all are staying safe and healthy. In today's video, I'll be featuring some of my favorites. These things have been things that I have discovered and loved over the course of the last 2 years. And I haven't done a favorites video in a very long time. It was something I used to do pretty much every single month. This is probably my first favorites in a very, very long time. Also, in today's video, I have a mini haul. There are certain things that I purchased and certain things that were sent to me as gifts. Some of them are there. And I will show you their brands from actually fellow creators, which I'm pretty excited to try out. I haven't really tried them out yet, but I will definitely do so. And also another thing, if you think that I'm glowing and all, no, I'm sweating. Let's get started. Okay, so the very first thing that I want to talk about is my dermal piercing. I don't know if you guys have seen the reel I made. It's going to be on my Insta and I'll have it linked down below. I'm really enjoying this look, you know. I haven't still styled my outfits to make this shine. You know, I'm not so good with styling outfit. I've been enjoying my dermal piercing quite a bit. In case you guys are wondering, was it painful? So on the scale of 1 to 10, it hurts a little. I mean, of course it's gonna hurt you, you know, they're piercing a needle into your skin, but it's only for like 1/10 of a second. And maybe once they put the stud for like a few seconds, and then you of course have to take care of it. It's like a wound, it's like your ear piercing or a nose piercing. One of the things that you have to make sure is that, you know, your towel doesn't get stuck or you don't pull on it, accidentally don't scratch it. So you have to be a bit conscious of those things for at least a month or so. Now, even though sometimes I end up tugging it, it doesn't hurt a lot, but there was a child that I met when I was in Darjeeling. I went for this wedding. That kid tugged on it and it did hurt. So if someone grabs it and pulls it, yes, it can pain, but otherwise it's fine. You can bear with it. Moving on to my second favorite, and this is something that I have been using for I think 2 years now. And initially it did take me a little, like it took a few trial and errors to kind of get to a point where I knew what exactly I liked. So I'm talking about my Dyson Airwrap. So I've been using this device for almost 2 years now, and honestly it is one of the best things for people like me. My hair has been a big deal for me. Like, I hate when my hair looks messy. It has taken me 3 years, 3 to 4 years to find the right products that work for my hair. This device has definitely helped me a lot. And when I say people like me, I like to style my hair every single day. For me, styling my hair would usually take about 1 hour after I have washed it, conditioned it. It would take another hour to do the whole styling, like dry it, then I would have to straighten it, then I would have to curl it, because my hair wouldn't look good curled if it had all that frizz. I'm not really big on the whole straight look anymore. I tried it out. I had straight hair for like a couple years now. I really like my original curly wavy look. Right now this camera isn't picking up the details in the haircut. I will also link the place that I got my haircut done from. I love this haircut. Been looking for someone who could do this for me. I basically wanted a lot of volume in my crown area and a ton of layers which would frame my face, because I plan on growing my hair out and I want that whole wavy curly look. I will try to put a footage of my hair somewhere, how it looks in proper lighting. That is something I've also been loving, so add that to my favorites as well. And along with that, my Dyson has come in really handy. If you want me to do an in-depth video, I did one a few years back, but now that I've used it for a couple more years, I think I have a better opinion about it. And also, I have watched a bunch of videos where people have like not liked it so much, and I understand why, because this might not work for every hair type and it is quite an expensive device. So before investing in it, you definitely want to know if it's something that, you know, would work with your hair type. I believe you can actually go and try it out at the Dyson outlet in Palladium Mall. Do let me know in the comments below if you feel like you want to see an in-depth video on different hair types, so I can maybe ask some of my girlfriends to volunteer so that I can check how this works on different hair types. So I was staying at Devashree's place for a couple of days and she had these in her bathroom and I used it and I immediately fell in love. Like, I have been trying to find a shampoo and conditioner that gives me these results that I'm getting with this particular one right now. for so long. I can't even explain. This has reduced my hair fall, has made my hair manageable. I don't have to go and get any spa treatments done to fix my hair texture. It has made my hair even more voluminous and bouncy. And I don't know if you guys can tell the difference right now on camera, because whenever I'm on camera, I'm styling it properly. But even when I'm not styling my hair, this shampoo and conditioner has changed my hair game has changed my hair game so much. And I feel really bad because this is quite expensive. I had to save money separately. Like, I want to buy this. I waited for like almost a month before buying this. I kept contemplating whether should I buy such an expensive shampoo conditioner, but I'm definitely not disappointed, and it is totally worth the money because it's reduced my whole hair grooming time to half. Otherwise my entire hair would take at least 1 hour 45 minutes to get it to look decent. Also, this has repaired my damaged hair. So I'm talking about the Aveda Botanical Repair Strengthening Shampoo and Conditioner. They also have a mask. I'm on the edge. Should I get it? Should I not get it? I'm going to get that probably by Christmas for myself. And if anybody wants to gift me anything, this is all I want, okay? This is all I care about. One thing very specifically about the shampoo that I have noticed is the texture. It's kind of like a little sticky. It has a sticky texture and it doesn't lather up a lot. It does have a decent amount of lather. It doesn't like give you that extreme suds, which I'm okay with. I don't really care about all that suds, but it makes your hair shiny, glossy, manageable. I have done pretty much everything with my hair. I've bleached it. I have been ironing my hair with a iron box since I was like 13, 14 years old. I would keep my hair on the bed, put a towel down and on top, and I would like iron it straight. I don't know what the heck was wrong with me at that time, but teenage years. I've been damaging my hair for a very, very long time, and this has definitely made a huge difference. Like, on a scale of 1 to 10, if you ask me how much of a difference this has made, it's about 8. For the first time, my hairstylist while washing my hair said that you don't have hair fall. And that is something that I've been struggling with for so long. So yeah, I wouldn't have suggested an expensive shampoo and conditioner unless and until it's very good, because shampoo conditioner people don't really tend to spend that much money. But hey, if you have hair issues and if you think that you need, they also have minis, so you can buy the mini version and try it out first and then decide whether it's working for you or not. Because I did try the Aveda almond one. There is an almond something shampoo, okay, can't remember the name, cherry blossom, yeah. It was a decent shampoo. It did not really do anything extraordinary for me, but it was a decent shampoo. But so I would suggest that you try the minis out first and see whether it works for you or not. I wasn't disappointed, and I'm sure that you guys won't be disappointed either. Sticking with Aveda, I also bought these. Now, these are things that I have used in the past before. This is the Scalp Revitalizer. This is the Invati Advanced range, and this is their Thickening Tonic. I have used, me and Goldie both really love this. This adds a nice texture, gives you a lot of volume, and also gives you a little bit of shine. I use this on the first day of styling my hair, and I don't have to care about it. This is going to last me for at least a year, maybe a little more, because you just need a few spritz. You don't need a lot. You get around 100 ml, which is quite a bit. This in specific for my dandruff and my scalp. My scalp has had a lot of issues. I wouldn't say my dandruff has gone completely. I still do have it like once in a while, but given that it was something that bothered me for almost 4 years, this definitely made my scalp a lot healthier. I use this once in 3 days, a day before I wash my hair. So I wash my hair once in 3 days. So on the second or on the third day, depending on how it's going, I will use this and I will go to sleep. Next morning, I will oil my hair with any oil and then wash my hair off. And I want to really try the mask, and if I do get my hands on it, I will do a full video for you guys on this particular range. So, and I bought all of this with my own money. Nothing was sponsored, nothing was sent to me. That's it with the hair. Now, when I was in Darjeeling, it was so cold. It was like 8 degrees, 6 degrees, okay? Freezing, bone chilling cold. All my products have frozen, like the moisturizers are frozen. You can't open anything over there. So I did carry this with me, and this was the best decision ever. This is the Pixi Vitamin C Priming Oil. Me and Goldie both used this as a moisturizer. So it has three layers. I just shaked it up really quickly. It's a very watery texture, but at the same time has this nice oily feel, which sits really well, especially in cold weather. And over here as well, right now I have it underneath my makeup. You need to set your foundation if you have oily combination skin, especially in a humid place. But if you're somewhere where it's really cold, you just can use this and put your foundation on, and it's gonna look beautiful. It won't crack, you won't have white patches. This was sent to me, but I'm not getting paid to talk about it. It was something sent me a few months back in PR. Love it. Amazing product. I also purchased Koqal's Rosehip Oil. This is Komal's brand, if you aren't already aware of it. I'm gonna have it linked down below. I'm so proud of her. So freaking proud that, you know, she's launched her own line. And this is what the bottle looks like. It's so pretty. I haven't had the chance to carry this along with me for the trip because, you know, my bag is getting really heavy. I'll definitely try this out and let you guys know my thoughts on it. Moving on to products that I carried with me, which I also bought. Forest Essentials, you know, afterbath oil and their shower gel. I bought this mini kit. And I also got like a few things free. Not really. I got the same thing free. You know, the body milk I got free. And I think this is the body wash again. And a soap. Their luxury sugar soap. Cute soap. I didn't use those things at all. We only used this. Now, the body wash is like a decent body wash, okay? It smells nice. I love this fragrance, by the way. The Oudh and green tea fragrance. You should try it out if you're into Oudh. This body wash is like any other body wash, but the body oil, I have loved this particular product for a very long time. Now, when my granny was alive, she had severe diabetes and her skin would dry up really, really bad, and we had to give her sponge bath. So we would add a couple drops of this into the bucket and then give her sponge bath with it, and her skin would stay soft and supple and not itch. The fragrance of this reminds me of her so much. And we ended up using this more because our skin was tearing, at least mine was, like everywhere. Arms were white, my knees were white. So we would take bath with this, and this would keep our skin nice and hydrated. If you're using a body moisturizer right now, after you've taken a bath, try using a body oil while you shower. I have been loving this foundation and blush combo. I have it on right now. This is Kiko Milano's, the stick foundation and the stick blush. Love, love this shade. It's this very pretty coral shade. It looks so nice. And their stick foundation, I'm in the shade 5.5. Now, this shade, okay, looks a little yellow if you try to go full coverage. But if you want to do a very sheer look, which I personally really like for every day, it blends in perfectly with my skin. Now, if I had to go full coverage with this, I would probably need a lighter shade to mix in with this, which is not as yellow. I used pretty much only this throughout my whole trip in Darjeeling. This can get a little drying if you don't use the right base, the foundation. But the blush is very hydrating and gives you this juicy, glossy look. I don't know whether the camera is picking up the color intensity, but because from my perspective, it doesn't look very intense, but in actuality, it is quite pink. I bit myself. Now, this is something I discovered when I went to Debashree's place. She had this entire range, okay, of this particular lip product. And I thought I'll do a swatch video. It's like, okay, let me try and swatch these. She was very sweet enough to let me swatch her lipsticks. And while I was swatching it, I ended up toppling my camera. My lens broke. I had to go get a new lens because my lens cannot be repaired. And also another thing I noticed is while filming, while I was swatching this, so this particular range stains your lips so much that it's impossible to use two colors back to back. Like when I'm filming a swatch video, I'm swatching shades back to back on my lips. Wait up, let me get rid of this mustache sweat. So whenever I'm swatching a lipstick range, I'm swatching shades back to back. I'll swatch a shade, apply foundation, remove it, apply foundation, swatch another shade. But you can't really do this with this range. And I did write to the brand if they would be okay, sponsoring products for me to do the swatch video. They never responded and they were like, nah. I was like, so I'm going to buy it on my own. I only have two. There are 11 shades in the range. I bought only two right now. So this is the Colorbar Sexy Kiss Proof Gel Lip Color. So I initially thought that it's going to be like those glosses. But this formula is very unique. So if you're looking for a product that's going to stay underneath your mask and not smudge, this is something you should try. But the color range is a bit, I was expecting the color range to be a bit better, because when you look at the product in the tube, okay, they have very distinctive shades. Like this definitely looks like it's a orangey pink, and this looks more of like a pink Barbie pink, but not Barbie pink, but pink. This is more coral, this is more pink. But when you actually swatch them on your lips, they turn really dark. They're very dark. So they look very, very dark. They don't look like what they are, what you see in this, tube, little tube thing. You have to go a little sheer with it. This has a very nice gloss-like finish, but the gloss fades away after a while, and then you have this beautiful stain that stays on your lips for a very long time. These are kiss proof. These don't transfer, but they do, however, transfer if you lick your lips. So if you lick your lips, or if you make your lips wet and then kiss somebody or anything, like you kiss yourself, it will transfer. But it won't transfer if your lips are dry. Once I get my hands on the entire range, I will do a full video for you guys so you can see the difference in each color. Most of them end up looking like this reddish, have this reddish tint. This one, this shade is called Cheeky. This is in the number 9. This has more of a purple tint. And this one is called Racy, number 11, which is my favorite one so far, because this is what I've used pretty much the whole trip. This has a very red tint. So this came in PR from Smashbox. I got a Smashbox PR after a very, very long time. So they sent me their Always On Matte Duo. So this is Big Spender and this is Stepping Out. I think I have swatched Big Spender on my Instagram. I'll have that link down below. And I haven't swatched Stepping Out, so I'm going to swatch this since I have a brand new tube. The formula will spread really well in the swatch video, because these tend to dry up if you keep them for too long. But really great liquid lipsticks. I have tried them in the past. And thank you for sending this to me. This is only available on Nykaa. It's written right here. So now this was something again gifted to me by Debashree. She was very sweet. She had an extra set, so she gave me this one. This is the Mario Badescu range. So this is their AHA Botanical Body Soap. And this is their Enzyme Cleansing Gel. Oh my god, let me first start off with this. Okay, this is a face wash. I've been using it for about a month. And that's how much I've used up. And I think this is going to last me for the next whole year. Because that's a lot of face wash. And I don't use this every single day. I use this every alternate day. And this helps in getting rid of your dead skin cells. Like whenever I wash my face with this and come out of the shower, and then I wipe my face with a rough towel or something, like a skin, like dead skin keeps peeling off. It's so satisfying. I love it. Have definitely noticed a huge difference in the way my skin looks and feels. I do take it a little easy though, because if you overdo that, there were a couple of breakouts. and I did use it for a couple of days and then used it and it was fine again. And this also is something I absolutely love. So during the whole lockdown and the last 2 years, I didn't shave my hands or I didn't care to do any of that. And there was quite a bit of buildup which was giving me, like, I had these little bumps on my elbow around this area and on my knees, on my thighs, basically strawberry skin, if you know what that means. And this got rid of that. Like, seriously, I was so surprised. This helped in, you know, exfoliating the skin on my body, and I really love it. This is not that expensive. This is around 800 rupees, I believe, 800 rupees. And I've used it for about a month, and that's how much I've used. I use this one, every two days, then I don't use it, then I use it for two more days. It depends. Like, it's not like I have to use it every single day. I have other soaps as well. I have way too many soaps. Okay, speaking of skincare, Dr. Sheds was a brand that I discovered during the lockdown, and I think I first saw Ankita talk about it, Ankita's post on it, and that's how I bought this. This is their Haldi and Hyaluronic Acid Sleeping Mask, but I also use it as a moisturizer at times, and this is what kept our skin from breaking when we were in Darjeeling. Also, if you're a big fan of hyaluronic acid, you're gonna love this. This makes your skin really plump, hydrates it, looks really nice and feels really great. So I've been a big fan of their Extra Gentle Daily Peel. I have finished 2 bottles of this. Okay, and they came out with a medium strength peel. So a couple of my friends who bought that on my suggestion also said that it did give them a bit of a rash because it was a little too harsh on them. Now, I have really strong bulletproof skin. My skin has gone through quite a bit, and for some reason I have managed to it can take a lot of damage, okay? So that didn't really break me out. It gave me like amazing refined smooth skin, but obviously there are people out there who have sensitive skin. So they came out with a medium strength peel. Also, they changed the packaging because this packaging was a little, the plastic pump was squirting the product in a different, like, in a weird manner. It would splash everywhere, and it, some of the bottles came in with like a broken pump. So they have now, I believe this is the new packaging for pretty much all of their products. This is in a glass bottle, and the pump is a lot more smoother and nicer. Also, the medium strength peel is something I use every single day. Gives me pretty much the same result, and it's less, it's not as tingly as that one. This is a little less tingly. So if you have sensitive skin, you can give this a shot. I'm sure you're gonna love it. So Anam sent me her entire lipstick range. First of all, I'm so proud of you. Oops, I dropped a note. So proud of you, Anam. This is really, really amazing. It takes a lot of courage, okay, to make something and put it out there for the world to judge. And she sent me a cute little note, which is so sweet. It's a handwritten note. And I will be doing an entire swatch video on this on my YouTube channel, and also a few posts on my Insta. So keep an eye out for that. This is her brand. It's called Wearified. I'll have her Instagram page linked down below. I'm going to show you guys the packaging really quickly so you guys can see in case you have missed it for some reason. This is what the packaging looks like. I love the fact that, you know, you have to screw this open. Oh wow, this is such a pretty nude shade. This is in the shade Monday. This is such a pretty shade. I don't want to swatch it before I click pictures, so I'm so sorry, but I love this shade. It looks really pretty. And the star purchase. So I have been eyeing a Huda Beauty palette for so long. I actually wanted to get the retrograde, the Mercury retrograde palette, but that was out of stock, and this I got on sale. This was the only thing, this and the Aveda thickening spray was the only two things that I purchased from the Nykaa Pink Friday sale. I have been wanting to get a new eyeshadow palette. This is so freaking gorgeous. I'm gonna actually do like a video with all these shades, and this one is so interesting. I don't feel like swatching it at all. It's called Slippery. It's like this glossy eyeshadow, which has little pigmented balls in there, and all the other shades are so pretty. I'm going to click a picture and then, you know, do a swatch. So, and also stay tuned if you want to see looks using this palette, because I plan on featuring every shade. It's so pretty. I have not bought a new eyeshadow palette in like 4 years now. So those were my favorites. Some of them were things I bought, some of them were things that I got in PR, and then some of them were gifts from friends. I hope you found this video helpful in some way, and if you want me to do anything specifically on any of these products, do let me know in the comments below. And I'll see you all really soon. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow me on Instagram. Please, I beg you guys, please follow me on Instagram. I don't know how long I've been stuck at the same number on both my platforms. It's just devastating. I don't see growth at all. So yeah, I would love to hear from you all. What have been your favorites? And yeah, I will see you all pretty soon. Bye.